Hello everybody, I'm Henry Lee, blueheronarts.com. Now we are at the Symphony Tower activity room, or social room, as they call it. Behind me, you can see some silk screen panels. There are 5 on each side and 3 behind me, so 13 of them. This is a joint adventure, joint hand collaboration with an artist in Hawaii. Her name is Shirley Poo Wills. Shirley has done an excellent work to lay out the composition and did some very powerful strokes. And due to health reasons, she could not finish the final stage of this painting. So I was involved as a cooperation with Shirley to complete this large project. The painting I'm going to work today is the landscape with a trip to the big island where Shirley and my dear friend Shay lived. I had a chance to see the black lava from the volcano, and just looked like exactly like that stone. So I got some inspiration and some idea. And I saw the beautiful clouds in the morning, lower clouds with the mountain top and the seascape or waterfront. So we got this theme of a waterfront garden with a distant mountain, some coconut palm tree, coconut island in the middle ground. That's what I'm trying to add to this. We already got the atmosphere here with the morning fog. So I will start to this corner with some palm trees that I laid out with a light sketch with a soft little charcoal. This is to help me to kind of see the proportions so I don't make a mistake in composition. And I'll do it too with a large stroke, large brush to create a calligraphic strokes. So I'm going to start with some chunk, I think. With the tip concealed, you might call it a tip-centered stroke. In one brush stroke. The dry stroke. Okay. Then we can add some little texture later. So do some very characteristic palm leaves. I've seen them in the morning where I woke up from the hotel, this beautiful place called the Hilo, I think. Always pay attention to the groove. You
visual stroke is important, but not as important as the whole, the shape of the tree, you know, like that. Should not be symmetrical. Actually, this coconut, so just do some circles there. Suggestively. And they usually have to cut it before it falling on people's head. You can get the main shape down with this stem. And then you add this leaf. I will make this part of a lesson. So we'll do some more life sketch, maybe during our stay, and then do it on rice paper. This is silk. It's not absorbent, and because it's also it's a very hard, like a canvas. It's mounted on a piece of foam board, so it's not absorbent. Let's make it difficult for spontaneous painting. It's very different, this coconut palm from the normal palm, like what we see in LA, Southern California. I like this longer stems. The swing of them in the wind is very romantic. So it's just the impression of that. And I will work some more details and maybe add a few more in the clouds. I'm going to do focus on this area. I'm going to add a bridge first. Person walking on this bridge, I will make that connect to the island. It could be a fisherman or someone. I just make an ancient poet. Rain jacket or in rope, whatever. This should be the pole. Okay. and just make it. All right. Okay, now next we'll do more trees in the foreground. I will honor this cloth. Maybe we just do partially covered trees. In the class to make the tree feel taller, like with the class in the middle. This, I think it's behind the cloth, so we don't have to do them now. Now I can dart a little texture. This side, that horizontal lines. This reminds me of the lotus thing. You can dot them, but this is not a dot, it's sections of a like the horizontal. Okay. Now we can dilute the ink with a little water. Add more trees in the distance. There's big clouds you may not see according to the different light. You should see that. And I just do a little island kind of behind the clouds, another dimension. could be a golf court or some resort. Yeah. Hear that sound, right? It's silk. So, just some more trees in the back. It should be one tall, one short. That makes a difference. The distant one, you don't have to do much details. Just do the shape, the main branch. Some dance, some sparks. Okay, so we did a palm harbor kind of a fishing village. Now we're going to extend that suggestively on this middle section, just a little suggestion of that. Then we'll continue to the left side. So this could be a tree in a close-up view, just the top. In the clouds. We are back to this corner. I try to add another group, so make this three palm trees. So this one will be together with this to form a dense relationship with the sparks. And when you plant two trees, you want to do one tall and one low and one big, one small. So that's all you want to vary. This could be a young tree. That's about it. Everyone,
Welcome back. Now we're going to continue the project with palm trees. So we're going to add some palms behind this giant rock. And you can see white clouds already going on there. So we just add some behind. Now next we're going to do the building behind this palm trees.